plant trees by Manning Builder Jordan in Youth Championships. In the final for the under 17 division, Reevo Maimre representing Finland, sorry, Estland. His opponent, Riku Rumpunen, is representing Finland. Referee Alan Bujas from Croatia and scorekeepers Neko Petrovic from Bosnia and Herzegovina. And in the final for the under 17 division is playing on table 2. And on table 1, the final for the under 19 division, Yannick Pongers representing Netherlands. And his opponent is Mika van Berkel, also representing Netherlands. Referee Gintaras Petrovas from Lithuania, and scorekeeper is Simonas Indrasius from Lithuania.
Player, you may leg for the break.
So, welcome everybody. So, just checking on the sound here. I have a bit of an echo. So, we are back again. Welcome everybody to the Dynamic Billiard European Pool Championships for the youth. This is the final of the straight pool division, the under 19s, and it's an all Dutch affair. Yannick Pongers against Mika van Berkel. This is a race to 100. Looking forward to this match. Yannick been playing really, really solid all tournament. A hot favourite against his fellow countryman, Mika van Berkel. Well, for those of you who are new to the straight pole discipline, there's no solids or stripes or number order. Ooh, that's got to go just about enough pace. Yeah, players here just have to nominate the ball and pocket and just keep the run going. Pot as many balls as possible, leaving the last object ball on the table in what the players call the sort of break shot. A little space where you want to leave the last ball to enable you to continue. It's actually one of the best disciplines to actually practice for all of the billiard disciplines. If you can master this game, an 8, 9 and 10 ball are relatively easier compared to this. You just saw there up in the crowd, the Dutch team. Well, Yannick looking to leave the red 3 ball as his preferred break ball. He's going to draw cue ball back up off side rail and just get square with that 3. Nice angle. Our referee will set up the rack with 14 remaining balls. That's the break shot that I mentioned earlier. Our senior referees, Gintaras Petrovas from Lithuania, in charge of this match here. We're a little bit behind schedule, of course. Yesterday, a massive thunderstorm hit the region, put power out in 3 cities around here. And very sadly, a few people lost their lives as well. So quite a severe storm. Electric actually came back on last night, a little bit before 8 o'clock, and we managed to finish the round that was still in progress when the storm hit. And this morning, players were up very, very early, 8 o'clock this morning. The matches started, and again tomorrow morning, we have to have another early round just to catch up. Hopefully, no more thunderstorms. Yannick causing a storm himself here on the table. Quite a big cluster there in the centre of the table. He's going to have to try and pick a few of the balls off from the outside. We think he'll take this 2 ball first. And there, he's either left himself that combination. Yeah, 15 ball he's calling. Gentle nudge. Well, the green 6 ball is now looking like the favourite to stay on the table. Oh, he needed that to travel a little bit further out of position now. Wanted to really take the red 11, stay down there for the 8, so he's going to have to travel. And that now leaves him to use the 8 ball as the break shot. Ideally, would have liked the 6, but that positional play to the 11 has forced his hand. And just left himself enough angle to send the cue ball off the bottom rail into the back of the pack there. And Yannick very, very capable of running the 100 required. This year, actually, Yannick took silver medal in the men's division of the straight pole. That was just recently in Finland in June, so not long ago. Pretty decent effort. Yannick, 18 years of age, competing with the men as well. His medal tally in the youth as well last year really took off, actually, in 2022 was his best year. Got a nice little kiss on the back of the pack there, split the balls. So yeah, it was really his best year on the European Championships. He took gold in the 8 and 9 ball, silver in the straight ball, and his 5th in the 10 ball. So a very good all-round player. Of course, Mika van Berkel is not a slouch either. Decent player indeed. And last year picked up the gold medal in the 8 ball in the under-17s, moved up to the under-19s this year. Just missing out on a medal last year, taking 5th place in the under-17s. There he is, waiting to see if he gets a chance at the table. That's one of the punishing things in straight pole. If your opponent is at the table, there's not a lot you can do except for sit and watch and hope that you're going to get a chance. Got to slowly start thinking about the 3 balls that are sitting together. 6 ball is a gap, it goes to the corner. Not sure about the red 11. And then you got the yellow 1 in the middle. So here goes the 6. Let's see if he can nudge the others, open them up a little bit. Well, he did, and the 11 went as well. So 2 balls off of that shot. Again, Yannick choosing a little bit forced with the issue to take balls from behind the rack, and he's really out of position here. Left the cue ball a little bit too low. Gonna leave himself a high cut here now. Got to be careful, don't want a cue ball getting stuck up in the back of the pack. It's always a bit of a risk when running into the pack from behind. And Mika van Berkel lost the lag, had to break off And since then, it's been the Yannick Ponga show. 42-0. Three racks already ran. That's what I was talking about, getting frozen up and stuck behind the pack. I don't think there's an easy way out here for Yannick. He cannot get to that 12 ball. Well, certainly not to take it directly to the corner. Sure, if he's left that now for Mika. Mika van Berkel comes to the table, trailing 43-0. I did hear a shot call. Is it direct? Looks it. So Yannick leaving a gap. Oh, banking. He did call it. Well, unfortunate there for the young Dutchman. Cue ball travelling through. And nothing staying down here to help him out. So he's going to have a tough shot now. Again. Attacking this. Called the bank shot. Called the 13. To the opposite corner. Nicely done. Close to the centre, but he's good. Great shooting there from the young man. Brave. Nicely splitting the blue 10 and brown 15. Everything in the open now, all about positional play. Oh, Mika van Berkel starts himself off with a nice 13 after Yannick's Positional error there. Oh, positional coming in off the back rail, getting frozen to the rack. Mikko van Berkel got a chance now to make his mark, trailing 43-12. Van Berkel now certainly improved on his previous best in straight pole. Fifth place was last year, 2022. That was in Petrich, Bulgaria. And 2019, it was ninth place. This medal will be a welcome thing. He's still got a shot on the pink 12 to the centre. Neat combination. Well, now there's a chance here. You can take the nine ball, come up off the bottom rail, split the cluster there. Got the banker of the eight ball to help him out. The couple, but didn't really get the split he was looking for. Still the cluster of three in the middle there. Oh, making a couple of balls off of that shot. Andy split the two red balls there, the 3 and the 11. Got a bit of a gap. Can take this 11 to the corner. Blue 10 up the side rail. Be leaving most likely the orange 5 as a break shot. A 4-6, then come back down for a red 3 for position on the 5. A little draw back here. I'd like to be sort of square with that orange 5. Draw it back a few centimetres. Looks perfect. Very nice shooting indeed. Both these players showing their abilities. Yannick starting off with a nice 43 break. Mikko van Berkel so far 27 to his name. If you have just joined us, this is the finals of the under-19s European Championships in the straight pole division. very nice split as well. It's the second time now he's had a look at the green six. Now after this shot, he's going to be coming for that to just to peek open a little bit the four in the middle there. Played that with a lot of pace. He wanted a better outcome though. Seven ball just creeping back towards the rack. I got rid of that straight away. It looks like he wants to leave the 13, stripe 13 as the break ball. Now from the 1 to the 2. Use the 2 to get position nicely on that 13. He left himself a little bit straight, wanted more of an angle, preferably. He's just about enough there, I think, just to clip the edge of the rack that the ref's putting together now. A pretty decent effort from a difficult place. Again, sort of got another break ball here. Oh, again, no reward really. Got a shot, of course. Green 14 up to the corner pocket. But that's tough. Cue ball very close to the bottom rail. Very, very unfortunate. Amigo van Berkel. good shot. Looks like he's going to be working his way back down table soon to take the round 15. I think it's the pink four, is it? Sitting in the rack. Got the right angle on this eight ball. Just wants to slide down the left side of the table, just past the middle pocket. Pointing to the spot on the table where he wants to plant the cue ball. And that is about where he pointed to, so I couldn't have placed that better. Now ball in hand, so terrific shooting from young Mika van Berkel, who's now in the lead. A nice 55 break so far. If you have just joined us, Mika van Berkel broke off and Yannick Pongers run 43. And from there, Mika van Berkel has taken over. Again, a nice little split there. Just got to try and pick his way through here. No real clusters, no real damage. A couple of balls just got to be careful with. Just in the middle there. Got the orange 5 and the green 14, for example. That's the 5-14 split. Making really nice work of this. It's a pleasure watching, actually. He left himself a little bit straight on the 7th. After possibly put a lot of draw on this, draw cue ball back off the side rail and back out into the middle. To travel again. I'm not sure if he's got the angle. Oh, he's looking up at the heavens, so I think there a very, very acute angle there. Not a lot for him to work with. I wonder what he's thinking. Penny for your thoughts. There we have the Dutch team and Yannick's young lady as well. The referee obviously seeing some on that 2 ball, giving it a good clean. And Mika van Berkel, is he too straight on this 15? Or can he conjure up some magic to continue this break? It's been really, really amazing watching. So yeah, safety called. So referee will place the ball back and use the rack again just to make sure all frozen. Can do that as long as the cue ball hasn't touched the pack. And always re-rack. If the cue ball had touched the rack on the way back, of course you cannot re-rack them. And if the ball didn't go in front, it would have to go behind. So Yannick making a foul there. No rail contact after the shot. Oh, he's missed the crucial shot there, that 9 ball. Well, got himself in the lead, a nice 70 break. Oh, Yannick. Wow, I did not see that coming. Looks like this eight ball is messing with the players' heads there. It was Yannick's miss on the eight ball. And Mika van Berkel's position from the eight ball. And the game changes again. Referee just reminding Yannick we have to wait until the balls have stopped moving. Mika van Berkel ruined his miss position from the dreaded eight ball. That was after Yannick missed the eight ball. Played a big part in this final. They have the Dutch coaches, players, girlfriends. Big mistake there. Positional error forcing Yannick to take a thin two down the side rail. Caught it a little bit too thick. Allows Mika van Berkel back to the table. still with a commanding lead here. Mika van Berkel can clear the remaining balls here. He will need two more racks made. He'll need a couple of balls from the last rack. These balls, a full rack, and two more for the gold medal. He has left himself the slightest of angles there on this one ball. (clears throat) 16 more points for the title. 14 from this rack and two more from the next. And Mika van Berkel, his first European title in the straight ball. He already picked up an 8-ball gold medal last year in the under-17s, stepped up a division, and is straight into the final. Again, a little bit unfortunate there. Bit of power into that shot. Only two balls sticking their head out, really. Important shot, this 11 ball. Missing the rack altogether. More down to the pace than Mika put on that shot there. Oh, cue ball is scratching. Well, there is some twists and turns in this final. Mika van Berkel could see the finishing line. Now Yannick Bongers comes back to the table himself, needing 45 points. Referee just aligning the ball at the back of the rail, at the back of the pack. Mika van Berkel actually very fortunate here. I mean, Yannick has the ball in hand behind the head string. There ain't a shot that he can actually attack this. Oh, I think he's going to leave that open for Mika van Berkel to attack again, and he's got the angle here. A little bit of right English. Be spinning into the pack there off the bottom rail. Doesn't need as much pace as he put on this last shot. The thin cut will allow the ball enough pace. Nicely done. Mistake, the nerves are creeping in. The nerves are getting to him. We just heard. Yeah, the under-17s, European straightball champion, Riku Rompanen from Finland. Look at the cue ball. Wow, wow, wow. There is some real twists and turns in this final. Both players come out of the blocks steaming. Bongo's making a 43 break. Van Berkel replying with a 70. Since then, it's been a catalogue of funny errors here. Little mistakes creeping in as both players vying for the title. tiny home on the chat there. It's a race to 100. Mika van Berkel getting closer. Van Berkel needing 7 more balls for the title. 93-58. Reading through the chat there, yeah, 100 games of 8 ball, huh? That'll be interesting. Now, straight pull, we're in. And Mika van Berkel needs 7 more points. That's one of them. 6 more now. Van Berkel made a very nice break earlier, was trailing Pongus 43-0. He came to a table, made a nice 70 break, put himself in command. As I said a little bit earlier, since then, a few mistakes have been creeping in. They've been trying to offer the gold medal to each other, basically. Van Berkel now. That's almost got the trophy in the bag. Four more. Three more balls for the title. Mika van Berkel defeats Jannik Pongers in the under-19 straight ball final here in Potocek, Slovenia. That was a little bit of a masterclass from both of these. Really enjoyable to watch. And Jannik Pongers resigned to the silver medal again in this discipline and division, his second year running. The award ceremony will take place on Thursday, I think it is, with the 10 ball. Yeah, you were just hearing that. It's going to be at the same time as the 10 ball, but we are going to start with the 10 ball matches this evening. Just a little bit of a change around, and then we'll be back. And you can watch all of the matches live. Just go ahead. Go to epbf.com and click on the live button. Hope you enjoyed it. Share the streams and like the pages. Thanks for being with us and see you all again later. Bye-bye for now.